What is it, Doctor?
It's the people from the capsule.
Capsule? People? What people?
The people Data beamed over.
I wasn't aware that he had.
Well, he did. And they were frozen. I thawed them.
You what?
Well, I didn't know what else to do. The crypts in which they were frozen were literally falling apart.
So what's the condition?
Right now, they're all sleeping. Each of them needed minor medical attention. Minor now, but then their conditions were obviously terminal. One had a heart problem, another an advanced case of emphysema with extensive liver damage. You know, the most surprising thing of all is that each of them had been frozen after they died.
After they died?
Cryonics. It was a kind of fad in the late 20th century. People feared dying. It terrified them. So, at the moment of death, they would be frozen, so that later, sometime in the future, presumably when medical science had found a cure for whatever killed them, they could be thawed back to life, healed, and sent on about their business.
In the case of this group, it apparently worked. Mr. Data, will you report to sick bay? Immediately. Look, I am never critical of any member of my staff being curious, but it's just that the timing was so...
I could not leave them there, Captain. The condition of their vehicle was deteriorating.
But Data, they were already dead. I mean, what more could have happened to them?
I see your point, Captain. But at the time, it seemed the proper thing to do.
Well, they're alive now. We're gonna have to treat them as living human beings.
Alive and well and ready to be awakened.
Look, before you wake them up, I want to have security here. Lieutenant Worf, report to sick bay.
I have them sedated now, but they should be up and about as soon as possible.
Well, then we have no other choice.
None that I can see.
Welcome to the 24th century.
I was able to retrieve some information from the ancient disk I removed from the module's computer. Her name is Claire Raymond, age 35, occupation homemaker. Must be some kind of construction work.
She died of an embolism. It probably happened very suddenly, otherwise her physical condition was excellent.
His name is Ralph Offenhaus, age 55, occupation financier.
Advanced cardiomyopathy. Inoperable at the time, but easily correctable now. He must have known his condition was terminal for quite some time.
Much of his file we could not retrieve. His name is L.Q. Sonny Clemens. Apparently his occupation had something to do with music.
There was marked deterioration in every system of his body, probably from massive chemical abuse. Unbelievable.
Sounds like someone who hated life. Yet he had himself frozen, presumably, so he could go through it all again.
Too afraid to live, too scared to die.
Doctor, this seems to be a situation more suited to your talents. I'll leave it with you. I'll be on the bridge.